Moist.
Right, as you saw in the last video, we are back from Turkey. As you can see, a little bit of a tan, newer, fresh, fake arms.
No, I honestly could never spend this much on a t-shirt.
Anyway, a little bit of a tangent there. Let's get back on track. In today's video, I am going to be rating my A-level choices: maths, further maths, physics, and chemistry. Now, I'm going to be rating them based on three different factors, all 1 to 10, to give an overall score out of 30. So those three factors are content difficulty, basically how difficult is the subject as a whole, content interest, how interesting is the subject as a whole, and third and finally, how easy is it to revise and get a good grade in it. And then obviously at the end I'll have a subjective conclusion as to like how much each has helped me and whether or not I'd actually do it again going back.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's get straight in. First subject, chemistry. I'd make some motions with chemistry. Like, I loved it and then I hated it and I loved it, I hated it. And I kind of just go through like a roller coaster of those emotions. But content difficulty, that is a mad one. Obviously, it depends on who you are as a person and your strengths. My strengths were in the sciences and the maths, but very much towards the maths and the physics side of things. So at first, the content could be quite difficult to understand. And it was one of those subjects that I would really go down rabbit holes quite easily when it came to the content. Like the understanding, or to be able to achieve a really solid understanding of all the concepts, you'd have to go to like university level. You could get away with understanding the basis of it, but I was one of those people that would like really dig down and understand why something happened, and if I didn't know why, I just wouldn't be able to move on. I needed to know exactly why something was the case, and I would go down like so many different holes to get to that answer. And it was one of those subjects where there were so many different variables, and you'd end up going into the physics to understand the chemistry because everything is built on physics. So for that reason, the content difficulty, I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. So if you are like me and just want to understand everything and understand the rationale, it is going to be really hard to get your head around the concepts. But if you just want to go away with all of the information that you need to answer the exam and do well in the exams, it's not going to be too difficult. It's going to be relatively easy to understand. Sorry, not 8 out of 10. I forget that the scale is the other way around because it was so difficult. I'm going to give it a 4 out of 10 for content difficulty. Cool. Content interest. How interesting was the subject as a whole? Right, this is a weird one because I found it to be more interesting and like more exciting after I'd learned everything. Once I'd learned everything, it was really sick being able to apply it all and understand like how everything worked, and that was really enjoyable. But when it came to actually learning it, for the most part, the content was pretty interesting. But then when it came to things like the organics, like it did lose me a little bit. I wasn't really interested in finding like what compounds made different compounds. I was more interested in like the physics behind the reactions and things like that. So when it came to the organics, it did make me slightly bored at times, and I didn't really rate that side of things. But then like the mechanisms and plotting out the mechanisms, I did enjoy that. But because organic chemistry was a large proportion of the course and it was just mainly memorizing as opposed to actually understanding the processes and things like that, I didn't find it was as interesting as it could have been. And for that reason, I'm gonna give content interest, like it was for the most part pretty interesting, a 6 out of 10. Now, how easy was it to revise? This was actually a lot better because once you'd got to the basic level of understanding of the content, revision was pretty simple. Like for the organic, it was mainly memorization, so using Anki was super, super effective. And like I said, organic was a large proportion of the course. And then for the rest of it, it was really one of those things where there wasn't a huge number of ways that you could ask specific questions about the content. So doing loads of practice papers meant it was really easy to gauge pretty much anything that they could ask you. So for example, like organic mechanisms, you could learn the mechanisms and then you'd be able to answer any questions on it. For the maths side of things and like moles, atomic equations, whatever, once you knew the maths and understood the maths, you could answer again any question on it. All of the other things like batch titrations and the practicals, you just had to memorize the practicals. So Anki worked really well. You just had to know the content and then you just be able to regurgitate that and get full marks. And yeah, because of all of that, the fact you could memorize most of the content and there wasn't too many angles that they could take to ask questions about that content, revision was pretty easy. And for that reason, I'm gonna give chemistry a 9 out of 10 for revision and how easy it was to revise. Cool, so that gives for chemistry an overall score out of 30 of 22. Now, do I recommend taking chemistry? Quite honestly, yes I do. It was a really good subject, like I did enjoy it, but I would only recommend taking it if it allowed you to get onto routes that you were considering. Otherwise, there is no point putting yourself through the stress of the subject when you could do other subjects to get to where you want to be easier. Like for example, if you want to go into something like medicine, chemical engineering, some forms of general engineering, it is really, really valuable and lots of the content does align with that course's content or those courses' content. If you're going to do something like a language, business, economics, something like that, like I wouldn't recommend putting yourself through that stress. There is very little, if any, overlap between the course content and that subject's content. And for the demand of that subject, it might not be worth it. So really do consider whether it opens those doors, or if you just have like a genuine passion for the subject but aren't considering going down a route in it, it might still be worth taking. Right, maths. Okay.
Maths is an interesting one, so let's get right into it.
How difficult is maths?
Well, it depends quite honestly on how well you did a GCSE.
The A-level maths course just builds on those fundamentals. So if you really did understand the GCSE maths as a whole, you're not going to find the content to be too difficult at maths A-level. Like, it's pretty much the same relative difficulty as GCSEs were. But obviously, at GCSEs, you didn't know the GCSE content. So looking at the A-level content, it would be like ridiculously hard, but because you know the GCSE content, learning the A level is the same difficulty as learning the GCSE, if that makes sense. So the GCSE is the foundation. If you're not confident in the GCSE, you're not going to be confident when it comes to the A level. If you're confident in the GCSE, it's going to be no harder than learning the GCSE content. And for that reason, I'm going to give maths difficulty a solid 9 out of 10. Right. Content interest. Now, very, very subjective on here. The only reason that I found it really interesting was because I love maths. I love, like, concrete answers. And I love mathematical reasoning, all of that. If you don't like mathematical reasoning, if you don't like maths, if you don't like figuring everything out for yourself and learning different methods to do so without immediately seeing the relevance, you're not going to find it super interesting and it's not going to be as enjoyable. For me, I didn't really care about seeing the applications before I learned it. It was cool seeing the applications after, but it all depends on your teacher and whether they make aware of the mathematical applications of the stuff you're learning or not, which lots of teachers don't. I was lucky enough to have a teacher that did. But yeah, looking at the maths on its own and not considering the applications, the content interest, very subjective, but for me, it was an 8 out of 10. Like, I just loved it. And then finally, how easy was it to revise? We already know, like, maths, so simple to revise. All you have to do is pass papers and then iterate from those past papers. Like, if you get some stuff wrong, revise that content, get a better understanding of those concepts, tackle a new past paper and just carry on. In fact, I've actually got full revision methods for both chemistry, maths, physics and further maths. And maths was by far the easiest. If you want to watch that, links in the description, or you can click up there. But it pretty much is just past papers. So when it comes to maths and how easy it is to revise, solid 9 out of 10. So overall, out of 30, 26. Absolutely banging score. Would I recommend taking maths? Wholeheartedly, yes. It is applicable to pretty much anything you do in life. And that was completely reaffirmed speaking to all of the students on different courses. Even in things like psychology, you have to do statistics, you have to do some maths, and you learn all of that in the A level. If there's one subject I genuinely believe that everyone should take, it would be maths. It is godly and required for so many different courses. Right, before we get on to the final two courses, I know a lot of you are currently going to be doing your A levels or are going to be doing your A levels in the next few years. That is why I want to bless one of you guys with a tailored tutors subscription. So first of all, who the hell are Tailored Tutors? Well, Tailored Tutors are a revision resource that packs everything you need for your exams into just a single page. This page. They have concise, example-specific explanatory videos on every topic on the course. Revision packs explaining the importance of the topic, common questions, and then how you can tackle those questions when it comes to the exam. In addition to question packs covering all of the different types of questions that they could ask in that exam so you can practice them yourself. And they even have their very own proven successful revision method that you can use to absolutely obliterate your exam. And they've just gone through a massive revamp, so at the top you can see a slider that gives you access to all of the latest news, the revision method, the community Discord, and any other features that they will be releasing. Now the best part of this course is you have 24/7 support from subject specific tutors who are ready to just answer any questions you might have, and they will reply within 24 hours. Now they are giving a 7-day free trial, so if you want to check that trial out, top link in the description below.
And they've been absolute kings and blessed one of you guys with a full membership until your A-levels. So for example, if you haven't even started your A-levels yet, that's £1,500 worth of membership for free. So yeah, if you do want to enter the giveaway, follow my Instagram there. Follow Tailored Tutors Instagram there,
and then comment your Instagram handle with one piece of study advice that you wish you knew earlier.
And the winner is going to be announced on this channel on this date. So to find out if you won, don't forget to drop a subscribe, turn on notifications so you don't miss out. Because if you do win it and you don't find out, that is going to suck. Cool, moving on to the next subject, further maths. This one, love-hate relationship for sure. Starting with concept difficulty. Maybe it was just the fact that I was so burnt out after all of the standard math stuff. When it came to further maths, it just felt like a little bit of a step up, and on top of all of the maths I was already doing, it felt like such a chore. I genuinely love maths, but there is a point where you're doing too much maths, and I felt like it was borderline at that point. Didn't quite reach it yet, but it was borderline there. And yet again, the A-level maths kind of paved the foundation for the further maths, so again, it was one step up, and because you were still revising all of the A-level stuff and weren't fully confident with that yet, it's a bit like the gap between GCSE and A-level, but A-level to further maths. Because you weren't completely confident in the A-level content, it made the further content harder, and for that reason, I'm going to give the difficulty for further maths a solid 5.5 out of 10. It is still better than the chemistry, but a little bit worse than the maths. Right, content interest, I'm going to be straight, I'm going to just go in with a score, solid 4. I know, rhymed, absolutely wonderful. But yeah, like, I think it was just the fact that I'd done so much maths by this point, and I was kind of burnt out. Still revising all the other A-level content,
content, but my interest in the stuff that I was learning, because the topics were much more niche and likely only used in more specialized applications, I was finding it hard to appreciate the value of the methods. And everything's great in moderation. Doing that much maths led me to not be as interested in it. And the fact that it became more chore to do the content meant that I didn't find it as interesting. But then finally, how easy is it to revise? Again, pretty identical to normal maths. It is really, really easy to revise once you've actually learned it. And if you can now put in the energy to revise it on top of the maths content. But as a standalone subject, it is really simple to revise. For that reason, I'm also going to give it a 9 out of 10. So, overall score, 18.5 out of 30. The worst so far. And would I recommend taking it? Now, there is only a very niche circumstance where I would recommend taking it. It was the only subject that I considered dropping out of the four subjects to save time and dedicate that excess time to the other subjects and focusing on those. I think the only time I would recommend taking further maths is if you are considering an engineering route and going into an engineering degree, because then the content overlap is quite significant and learning all of the further content is going to help you when it comes to your course and actually getting ahead of everything like that. Because for me, mechanical engineering, the first month or so was building on the further content and we were relearning a lot of it, so it just does give you that step ahead of everyone that didn't do it. Takes a bit of the pressure off, makes it a little less stressful. But if you aren't going to do an engineering degree, just the sheer amount of math that you're doing, you're going to have to absolutely love it. And if you don't absolutely love maths, there's not going to be much point. And you may as well choose a subject that you're more passionate about, something like physics, history, languages, whatever, just something different so that you're not spending like 90% of your time doing maths and you have a bit more diversity with the stuff you're doing on a day-to-day basis. That is what I would recommend. But at the end of the day, like, it's not a bad subject. I still did enjoy it. It just did get a bit stressful at times. Maybe that's because I did four A-levels and it just felt like maths was much, much more than everything else. But I don't know. It's just one of those subjects that you really need to consider a bit more. Okay. Finally, physics. Now, I am very, very much biased when it comes to physics because I absolutely love it. Like, I love understanding concepts behind everything that makes the world work. Looking at different phenomena and being able to explain exactly how it happens, like, that is just the sickest thing. So, concept difficulty. If you do maths alongside physics, a lot of the physics is just standard maths. There's a massive content overlap there, so it makes the content much, much easier. If you don't do maths, it's a little harder, but the concepts are relatively simple that you can pick it up quite quickly. With physics, because it is the fundamental of everything, there are a lot less rabbit holes than something like chemistry to actually unpick everything and get to the truth as we know it. Obviously, like, the world is changing, we don't know exactly how it works, we just have models that fit current observations, but it's cool being able to go straight to those current models and not needing to know like a gazillion other things in order to, from first principles, explain it. I love that. I found it really useful when it came to actually understanding concepts, and I didn't find myself having to spend hours at a time trying to unpick everything. For that reason, content difficulty, straight 9 out of 10. Absolutely loved it. Maybe I'm bias, but I found it pretty easy. Again, on the same note, content interest, straight 9 out of 10. Being able to understand everything around you was brilliant. I absolutely loved it. No more words needed. Now, how easy was it to revise? Well, again, most of it is just maths. Maths is the easiest subject to revise, and then everything else was just memorization. There were very few paths that the examiners could pitch questions around the content. So once you'd done a few past papers on each topic, once you'd reviewed the topic as a whole, you were pretty set for any questions they could ask you. Again, I've made a video on my exact revision method, but it was pretty straightforward. For that reason, I'm also going to give it a 9 out of 10. So, overall score, 27.5 out of 30. This is by far my favourite subject. I absolutely loved it. I would wholeheartedly recommend taking it if you love anything to do with maths, anything to do with physics or understanding the world, and really do want to dive into why everything works. But if you don't like enjoy that or don't think you're that kind of person, it is going to be pretty strenuous. It's probably only worth considering if you're going into something like engineering again, because it is so, so useful for that. And for me, there's a massive overlap when it came to the content of my mechanical engineering degree and the content that I learned in the A-level. Cool. Anyway, those are the rankings of all of the subjects based on my subjective experience. Again, if you want to ask any questions on any of the things I said in this video, or like I didn't answer specific questions that you had coming into it, drop them in the comments and I will try to answer as many of them as possible. Otherwise, I do hope you've enjoyed this video. If you want to see a lot more content like this, as well as all of those vlogs and all the content that I mentioned at the start of this video, I would absolutely love it if you could drop a subscribe, turn on those notifications, whack the like button if you didn't enjoy this video. Otherwise, yeah, hope you enjoyed. I'll see you in the next one. I live inside my own world of make-believe.